Hello students, good morning. Welcome back to our next class. In our previous class, we have the new topic, that is we have learned about the tied ranks. So what are tied ranks? Whenever you get the repeated values, for that repeated values, you will get a tie rank. So whenever you get a repeated value, what we will do? We will assign the average of those ranks in the place of original ranks. Now we will see a problem related to the tie ranks. So coming to the problem, following are the marks of the students for two subjects. So here only the marks are given of two subjects. So marks in subject A and marks in subject B are given. So we need to find the rank correlation coefficient. So here only the marks are given. We need to assign the ranks carefully. If there are any tied ranks, we will use the tied rank formula. So if you observe, here you have 68, 68, 68. It is repeating. So whenever you have a repeated value, you will use tied ranks formula. So in the solution, first write down the formula for the tied rank. Spearman's rank correlation coefficient for the tied ranks is, so it is denoted with the same notation, rho equals to 1 minus 6 into, for summation di square, you will add the correction factor di square plus correction factor divided by n into n square minus 1. So what is the correction factor here? Correction factor equals to mi into mi square minus 1 by 2. Here m equals to what number of times a value is repeated. Number of times value repeated is m value. I equals to number of values repeated. So here m means, here 68 is repeated 3 times. So m value will be 3. I is what? Here 68 is repeated 3 times. And if you observe some other values, here also 66, 66. So that means how many values are repeating? That will be represented with I, and how many times it is repeating, it is represented with n. Now we have to assign the ranks and calculate the correlation coefficient. So how we will assign the rank? Similarly, how we have done on the previous problem. So say first we have to draw a label. So marks of subject A, I am writing as X, and marks of subject B, I am writing as Y. And next I have to write ranks of XI, ranks of XI's. Next, ranks of YI, next DI and DI. So what is DI? Rank of XI minus rank of YI. So write down here DI equals to rank of XI minus rank of YI. So first write down the X and Y values as it is. First value is 65, 63, 67, 64, 68, 62, 70, 66, 68, Preceding values will get the next ranks.
Sorry, we have 468. It's not
3, we have 4 68s. So 1, 2, here 3, here 4. 4 68s are there. So after 3, we have 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 by 4. You have to take average of 4 ranks, that is 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7. So the average is 5.5. So here the rank will be 5.5, and here also 5.5, and 68, 5.5, and the last 68, 5.5. So 7 ranks are finished. Next you have to write the 8th rank. So after 68, next number is 67, and 67 is only 1. So after 7th rank, you will get the 8th rank here. Next after 67, we have 66, 1, 2. You have 2 66 and the next ranks are 9 and 10. So you will get an average of 9 plus 10 by 2. So 9 plus 10 by 2 is 9.5. So 9.5 here and another 66 is here, 9.5. 10 ranks are finished. Next is 11th rank you have to assign. So if you observe 65, 65. So 11 plus 12, 11 plus 12 by 2 equals to 11.5, and here 11.5. So here also the last rank we are using is 12. So you have to get the last rank should be the number of values. So ranking assigning is finished. So don't get confused. So while doing only, you try to assign the ranks and try to catch the concept. Next is you have to find the difference, that is DI. So 9 minus 5.5. So what is 9 minus 5.5? It is 3.5. Next is 11 minus 9.5. 11 minus 9.5 is 1.5. Then 6.5 minus 5.5 is 1. Next 10 minus 11.5 is minus 1.5. Next 4 minus 3 is 1. Next 12 minus 9.5 is 2.5. Next 2 minus 5.5 is 3.5 minus 3.5. Next 8 minus 11.5. 8 minus 11.5 is again minus 3.5. 4 minus 1 is 3. Next 6.5 minus 8 is minus 1.5. And next 4 minus 5.5 is minus 1.5 again. 1 minus 2 is minus 1. Now you do squaring for this. Whatever the d values you have, for all those d values you have to find the squares. So first 3.5 square is 3.5 whole square is 12.25. Next 1.5 square is 2.25. You can check in Calci also. Next 1 square is 1 and 1.5 square is 2.25 only. 1 square 1. 2.5 square is 25 square, we know 625, so you get 6.25. Next 3.5 square is 12.25, we already got in the starting. Next again 3.5 square is 12.25, 3 square is 9, 1.5 square is 2.25, 1.5 square is again 2.25, 1 square is 1. Now you want the summation of this value, right? Summation d I square. So write down the summation d I square. If you add all these values, you will get summation d I square equals to exactly 64. So this is the summation d I square value. First you will have x values, you will have y values. Then you will find the ranks of x I, you will find the ranks of y I. Then you will find the I, that is the difference between third column and fourth column. So whatever the values you got in the fifth column, you will be doing squaring for that fifth column, you will get the d I square. Then obtain summation d I square, and then you have to find find the correction factor also. First, correction factor. First, you find the correction factor. So, how do you find the correction factor? First, see the repeated values. First, check in the ranks of x's, then go to the rank of y's. Now, first, if you observe here 6.5, 6.5, it is repeating 2 times. So, first, you write 2 into 2 square minus 1 by 12. Plus, next, see which ranks are repeating. Here, 4 is repeating, right? 4, 4, 4. It is repeating 3 times. So, you write 3 into 3 square minus 1 by 12. And see, there are any other repetitions. I think in x only 2 repetitions. 6.5, 6.5, and x. And come to the y. In y, how many values are repeating? 6 here. 5.5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 times if it is repeating. So, 4 into 4 square minus 1 by 12 plus. Then after 5.5, 9.5 is repeating. So, 9.5. It is repeating 2 times. So, you write 2 into 2 square minus 1 by 12. Then after that, 11.5 is repeating 2 times. So, last value is 2 into 2 square minus 1 by 12. So, this is the correction factor. So, don't get confused. In correction factor, you know, you don't need the ranks at all. You just need how many times the value is repeating. Only you have to check is how many times the value is repeating. Don't see the ranks. You may see that here 6 and 7 are repeating. So, don't take that 6 and 3 or don't take either 6.5. No ranks will be considered in the correction factor. In the correction factor, we will be writing only the number of times the value is repeated. Now, find the correction factor. That is equals to 2 into 2 square is 4. 4 minus 1 is 3. So, 2 into 3 by 12 plus 3 into 3 square is 9. 9 minus 1 is 8. So, 8 by 12 plus 4 into 4 square is 16. 16 minus 1 is 15. So, 4 into 15 by 12 plus 2 into 2 square is 4. 4 minus 1 is 3. So, 2 into 3 by 12. Next, plus 2 into 2 square is 3. So, 3 into 12. Now, solve this one. You will get the correction factor value. If you want, just take a screenshot of it so that you can practice how to assign the ranks. Now you find the correction factor value and substitute in the row formula. So for all the values, it is the same denominator, that is 12. So that if you take the simple, you will get easy, or you can cancel it also. That depends on you. So correction factor equals to, take, you can cancel them. I'm canceling there itself. 2 into 3 is 6. 6 by 12 is 1 by 2. Next, plus 3 ones are 3, 4s are 4, ones are 4, 2s are. You get here 2 plus 4 ones are 4, 3s are 3, ones are 3, 5s are 5 plus 2 ones are 2, 6s are 3, ones are 3, 2s are. So 1 by 2 plus same value, that is 1 by 2. So 5 plus 2 is 7. So 7 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is 1 plus 1 by 2, that is 1.5. So 7 plus 1.5, the correction factor equals to 8.5. So 1 by 2 is nothing but 0.5. So I took 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 as 1.5. So this is the correction factor. Now what is the row formula? Row equals to 1 minus 6 into summation I equals to 1 to n di square plus correction factor divided by n into n square minus 1. So what is the correction factor value we got? 8.5. And what is the summation di square? Summation di square value is 64. Now substitute all the values, we get 1 minus 6 into summation di square is 64 plus correction factor is 8.5 divided by, what is the n value? There are total 12 values. So 12 into 12 square minus 1. So solve this, you will be getting the required row value as this numerator value is 435 divided by the denominator value is 1716. So overall, this fraction value you will get the answer as 0.2534. 1 minus 0.2524. So that the final row value equals to 0.7496. Therefore, row equals to 0.7496. This is the required rank correlation for the value for the given problem. So therefore, the rank correlation, between the between the ranks of two subjects is 0.7496. So this is the rank correlation, that is whenever you have the tie. So what you will do? First you will write the formula, that is 1 minus 6 into summation di square plus correction factor. What is the correction factor? Mi into mi square minus 1 by 12. What is m? M is the number of times a value is repeated. If the rank 6.5 is repeated 3 times, you will take m value as 3. If your value 11.5 is repeated 2 times, you will take m value as 2. Like that, how many values are repeating, that many times you have to do the summation. Factor is nothing but summation of I equals to 1 to, only summation over I you write because we don't know how many values will be repeating. The summation over I into mi square minus 1. So I is number of values that are repeated. So here total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values are repeated. So I take the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So m is, if it is repeating 2 times, you will write 2 into 2 square minus 1. If it is repeating 3 times, you write 3 into 3 square minus 1 by 12. And if it is repeating 4 times, you write 4 into 4 square minus 1 by 12. So this is the problem for the rank correlation in case of the tied rank. Now tomorrow we will be seeing the next limitations of rank correlation. Similarly, for the correlation always lies between minus 1 and plus 1, right? Similarly like that, for rank correlation also we will be having the proof. Even the rank correlation lies in between minus 1 and plus 1. So tomorrow we are going to see the theorem and proof for that along with the one problem with the rank correlation.